What's going on, everybody? It's your bro here. Hope you're doing well. And in this video, I'm going to teach you guys all about grid layouts in Java. So sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. If you find this video helpful, please remember to like, comment, and subscribe. Your support will help keep this channel running. All right, everybody, let's discuss the Grid Layout Manager. So this places components in a grid of cells in a number of rows and columns, with each component taking all of the available space within its cell, and each cell is the same size. So to begin, we'll need a frame. We're going to add buttons to our frame. The frame is going to have a grid layout. So to create a frame, like always, we just say JFrame. We give it a name like frame equals new JFrame. Frame.setDefaultCloseOperation, JFrame exit on close. Give it a size, the size doesn't matter, and frame.setVisibleToTrue. So let's create a whole bunch of buttons. I don't know how many, maybe 9. So to create a button, we just type in JButton. We can give this a name like button1 equals new JButton. And then when we instantiate this, we can set some text to the button. So let's just pass in 1. And then we can add this button to the frame. So frame.add button 1. So there's a shortcut you can do that we learned in the last video on flow layout managers. This will still work, but just to save time, I'm going to shorten the lines of code that we have to write. So instead of creating a button with a name, we can create an anonymous button. So all we need to pass in when we add this component to the frame is instead a new JButton, and then you can set the text right away too. The other way works just fine. That just requires more lines of code, but do what you prefer. I'm just shortening this to save some time for us. So we're going to add a bunch of buttons to the frame to demonstrate a grid layout. So I'm going to create 9 separate buttons. All of them will be numbered. And once you have a whole bunch of buttons, it doesn't matter how many, we're ready to move on. With frames, by default, they use a border layout manager. So the components like to take up as much room as possible. So with this button, this number 9 button, it's taking up the entire frame and all the other buttons are hidden underneath. So we need to change the layout manager that we're using for the containing class, which is our frame. So frame.setLayout, and we're going to pass in a layout manager. Which layout manager? A new grid layout. Well, because that's what we're learning about. And when we run this, all of these components, all of these buttons are all arranged in one row and one column for each component that we have. But we can specify the amount of rows and columns that we want for this grid. We could say the first number is the amount of rows and the second number is the amount of columns. So here we have 9 rows and 1 column. So they will all be stacked vertically like this, and then they will expand to fit the size of the frame. But all of the components will also stay the same size as each other. Let's say we want 3 rows and 3 columns. This is what this might look like. So we have 3 rows and 3 columns. And later on in this series, we do create a calculator program as well as a game of tic-tac-toe. So a grid layout works perfect for those programs. Now, when we create our instance of a grid layout, we can also add some arguments for the horizontal margins and vertical margins between these components. So let's add 2 more arguments and we'll just set them to 0 for now. So this third position is the horizontal spacing between components and the fourth one is the vertical spacing. So if I were to set this third argument to 10, we're going to have 10 pixels worth of margin between these components, between each column. And this fourth argument is the vertical margin. So if you combine these both together, you have 10 pixels worth of margin around all of the components. Now, what happens if you have an uneven amount of components that you add to a grid layout? So we have 3x3, so that works perfect for 9 components. Let's say that we add 1 more. We're going to add a 10th button. Like that. So what happens now is that this will actually create a new column for us. So we have 3 rows and 4 columns, and it tries to make this as evenly balanced as possible. So that's the basics of grid layout managers. If you want a copy of all this code, I'll post all of this in the comments down below. But yeah, that's the basics of grid layouts in Java. Hey you. Yeah, I'm talking to you. If you learn something new, then you can help me help you in 3 easy steps. by smashing that like button, drop a comment down below, and subscribe if you'd like to become a fellow bro.